little bit of V8 action to be had with our forecast as well. Mark Winterbottom to be our guests. This is sort of a perfect fusion of the Bulldogs in Melbourne and a cherished part of this time of year. Normally we'd be counting down to the EJ Witten Legends game. That can't be, but we can support protecting legends and the new Rural Prostate Cancer Organisation, the merger. So, well, merger's probably a dirty word.
No,
so
we call it an amalgamation.
Very nice. Yes. Bill Guest, long-time Vice President of Melbourne. Bill, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, Jared. Nick, great to be here.
And Bulldog royalty carried in the name, Ted Witten Jr. Ted, fantastic to see you.
G'day, Jared. Nick.
What are the emotions like knowing that your two great teams are about to meet in a dream grand final?
Well, they're pretty high. Yes. Bill's been running around this week. Every media interview he's been doing, he's been promoting Melbourne, and I've been doing the same for the Bulldogs. So, you know, a bit of emotion around, isn't there, Bill?
Yeah, there is. Yeah, Ted and I had a little wrestle out the front when we arrived in there. We had a quick wrestle. But no, it's very exciting for both clubs, and it's great to have two Melbourne teams, and particularly, you know, well, you've won one in X number of years, and we haven't won since 1964.
And based on that, how high is the frustration level that you actually can't be there in person?
Shocking. I can't tell you how... I've been through so many tantrums, Nick. It's unbelievable. It's been unbelievable. I've tried every angle. Well, I haven't tried any angle, but I thought of every angle. Even thought of taking a guest furniture truck over there, but I've got a feeling that the New South Wales guy that tried that didn't go so well.
No,
so
that didn't end that well.
No, they'd have a very unhappy ending.
You'd have a few trying to pile into the back of your truck.
Yeah.
Was 54 legend in your house, Ted? EJ was a part of that when the last time the Bulldogs and the Demons met in a grand final.
Yeah, it was a big day, and obviously the only premiership for a long time, and it wasn't until 61 that we got another opportunity when we played the Hawks, when Dad was captain coach. But since then, been pretty dry. And of course, 2016 was just an unbelievable year and an unbelievable build-up. I was talking to Bill outside and saying, you know, that when we won that prelim final, that was bigger than big. It was just incredible that we actually made the grand final. And to go on and win it in 2016, as we know, it was all a fairy tale.
They're beautiful images to relive of 54. Bill, you were vice president when last Melbourne were in a grand final.
Yes, 2000. Yeah. Melbourne versus the Bombers.
It's a bit different this time, isn't it?
Slightly different. I mean, I'll give the great man Neil Dan enormous credit. We all went into that game thinking, you know, we're all convinced we're going to win. But the reality is, I think Essendon only lost one game against the Bulldogs when Wallace was coach. So, you know, in the benefit of hindsight, it was probably going to be a struggle. But this is a very different grand final for both teams, realistically, because we're both a good chance. So,
yes, it'll be hard to
say. Well, hopefully they're not all that good a chance. But anyway.
Friends, family, how are you all experiencing?
Yes, we're all demented. My son Sam, particularly, 23, he's a man, young Jake. So, Susie, the whole family, and all my friends, I've got a lot of sort of obsessed Melbourne friends, a lot of people you know, Jared, and we're all very depressed about not getting together on the night, but nothing we can do about that, sadly.
What shape will the night take then? How are you going to approach it?
Well, it's a good question, Nick. The alcohol will have a fair. You're probably not meant to say that on television, but
what time is it? We're past.
So that'll have we'll have a sort of a barbecue. I've got a bit of a rooftop terrace, so we'll sit up there and soak it in, and it's pretty good. You've got the Melbourne Storm now at 4:45, so we'll be very... But how we're going to contain ourselves, I'm not sure, because I'd love to celebrate with my mates. Anyway, it is what it is.
Tell us about Rural and how we can all get involved, given that we can't be at an EJ Witten Legends match.
Yeah, well, of course, the EJ Witten Foundation and Australian Prostate Centre have merged to create Rural Prostate Cancer, and it's all about protecting the legends in our family, our fathers, our grandfathers, and making sure they're around for a long time. And it's very important that men understand that, you know, prostate cancer is a silent killer, but it's bootable. We can control it. And through protecting legends and Rural Prostate Cancer, we hope to be able to do that and save many lives along the way.
So we want these bucket hats to be a feature of the summer, don't we, Bill?
Yes, we certainly do. They're very important, and donations are very important as well.
Put yours on, Bill.
I'm going to put the cap fits, wear it, don't they say that? Something like that. Exactly. We look good, Ted, you and I. I use the example which Ted was talking about. You know, if my wife or your partner tells you to go to the doctor, you may say yes or you may go to the pub. But if your son or daughter says, go to the doctor, Dad, because I love you and you're a legend in my life and I want you for my 21st birthday, whatever it is, you're more likely to go. So that's where we're targeting, hence rule, and, you know, parents are legends.
We need the EJ Witten game back. We need the legends game back because it's pretty much the only thing, I think, for past players that actually keeps them in check with respect to their fitness. because vanity's a pretty powerful motivator, and that's the one stage where you can actually get back out. And in its absence, I think a few boys have let themselves go, Jared.
Very good. Ted, it's great to see you.
Thanks, Jared.
And Bill.
Thanks, guys. Yes,
what would it mean?
Oh, I can't describe it. Yeah. It'd be unbelievable. It would be totally unbelievable. Right. Can I just quickly mention our website, ruralprostatecancer.org.au. Please buy a hat and donate.
Yep. Perfect. Well done. Bill, Ted, great to see both of you.
Thanks, guys.
Nick, fantastic.
Awesome. See you next week.
We've got a little bit to work out.
Yeah, we'll sort out our differences off camera, mate.
See you tomorrow night.
This has been a Fox Sports production.